Hello one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play No Man's Sky with me, eKKITHUMP. Here we are back at the farm. I've just actually been round and done a Mordite run, and it's regrown very fast. This stuff is, it seems to regrow about every 15 minutes. If we were concentrating on this, we could get an insane amount of cash from here. But look at this, the albumen pearl plant has grown and has spawned us its first pearl, which is worth 19 grand base. Let's see what it's worth on the market. Yeah, 19 grand. Alright, so I'm ready to go with the next planet. I've got my dynamic resonator and my hybridium and my voltaic cells for the Nomad Geobay. So let's warp up to the station. Warp up to the station from the warp chamber. And we shall see where we're going next. Not Bant. I think Nekiotasukuhiha was the station we were. The system we were exploring in last episode. Yeah, Nord land. So we should also have some warp fuel ready. See if there are any freighters in the system. But, I mean, Christ knows. Oh, these are asteroids. There's something over there, but I don't think it's a freighter fleet. We can have a nip over and see. I just want to go and check what sort of price we're looking at to buy a freighter. There we go. So we're going to find the captain to see how much he wants for this. I imagine it'll be more than 5 million, which is all we can afford at the moment. Hello! Welcome aboard. What brings you here? Freighter life rarely appeals to the independent pilot. Perhaps you need our services, some cargo hauling or some other business? An air of weary authority clearly marks this being as the freighter's captain. Do they tire of the burden of ownership, I wonder? The responsibility for the life and livelihood of their crew must weigh heavy on their mind. They seem amenable to an offer. A freighter brings access to a large inventory, a hangar bay in which to store multiple ships, and space in which to construct an orbital base. How much do you want? It is a fine ship, and the crew will serve you well. Only 19 million. To be honest, I got it in my head that it was more than that. Anyway, obviously we can't afford it now. But that might be within reach if I put in a bit of time to grind up some cash. I have to consider that, especially once we start getting up to about 10 million. I reckon the Mordite farm as it is can probably kick out about 600,000 units an hour. So we're talking about 14 million units. I would say about 20 hours grinding to get that much money? Holy shit, that's actually quite a long time. We'll wait until we've got a bit more money. Once we get the insulating gel farm going as well, that'll speed things up quite considerably. At the moment, I'm not actually using the spodonium and temerium we're producing to create insulating gel. I'm just using it to create more plants, so we get an eventual higher return. Oh well, anyway, where are we going next? Path towards the next Atlas interface. Hyperdrive has no fuel. Well, that's where we're going anyway. Right, Atiamagur. Maybe I'll do that next time actually. Maybe instead of going to explore a planet, I'll just do a grinding episode and see how much money I can get in one timed hour on Nibelheim. What in the fuck? That's a space station. Oh no. Oh. I was going to say. No, the space station's behind that. We haven't really got any... Oh, we've got plenty of oxides, actually. We've got a bunch of titanium. Maybe we can get involved here. Get ourselves in the mix. We've just got to be quite careful. We don't want to hit the freighter by mistake. I can't even see where any of this shit is. Come on then, you want some as well, do you? Another one down. Actually, we should recharge. That's it. Just fight and recharge, fight and recharge. Come on, I know that was you, shoot him in the ass. Okay, six to go. Let's get ourselves over there. Get the hammer down. Fuck, is this one on us? Why are you shooting at me, for God's sake? I'm literally the least threatening thing on the battlefield at the moment. Come on then, you bugger. This guy's pretty tough. Oh, Jesus. Okay, let's get it on them. Come on, shoot him! God, for some reason I'm can't roll upwards anymore. The ship handles slightly oddly in combat. I think I'm actually getting buffeted by the friendlies. We got one, I think. Why are the sentinels coming? I'm not raiding the freighters. What are you talking about? All right. Jesus. Fuck off. It was a mistake, it was just a bit of friendly fire. Okay, now we've actually got to try and escape the fucking Sentinel starships somehow. Oh, for God's sake! I think we may have to take a death. It's ridiculous, you can't escape them! As soon as one sentinel starship goes down, the next one just pops in. Yeah. Oh well. What's offline? Warp reactor theta. Oh god, that's quite expensive to repair. I don't know how we managed to piss them off. We must have... What? Did we get an achievement for dying? Oh no, we got notorious. Okay. Yeah, space combat battles are always so dicey. I mean, I get that... Oh, where am I going? Where's my grave? There it is. Yeah, I get that. Okay, I must have shot the freighter by accident, and that made the game think I was a pirate. How would you solve that actually? Because when you think about it, you might say, oh, well, they could just lock you in, lock you onto the friendly faction after you started fighting the pirates, but then. You could exploit that to just raid the freighter's cargoes, like while you were protected by friendly status. Presumably, that's what the game thought I was doing. Anyway. Take a death. That's that may actually be the first death in this particular season. It's not the first time I've died playing No Man's Sky, I don't think. But the first time I died was before I started the Let's Play, when I was doing a test run. Oh, there we go. Okay, we've got everything back. Now I don't think it makes a difference which planet we go to. We're at the point now where we don't need any of the purple resources for farming. I mean, no. Aluminium, iridium, and heridium. And tamarium, and gold, and iridium, and so on. Well, we were on a kind of shitty, horrible grey planet last week. I'm trying to figure out which one would be the most interesting. Where do we get... Why do I have all this crap on me? Are they being attacked again? Is it a different battle or is it the same battle? Well, whatever, we can't actually go in and help them now because we are completely out of oxides. We need to get down to the planet. In fact, yeah, let's get down to just the closest one. Accordion flu. Humid weather. I guess that means it's rainy. Right, we'll get the Romagia Bay down. Oh shit! Wrong one. Well, never mind. Hold on a sec. What was that I just saw? I thought I saw something purple then. Oh no, it's a detritum. So apparently you get detritum from different shaped rocks on different planets. On this planet, it's those big anemones. Ah, no, fuck! Fuck, hold on. Is this one... Oh, this one has got the double scanner, hasn't it? Yeah. Phew. It's also got the... Was it to shift modes? F? T? Fuck, how can I not remember this? Every week I have to check this. G? There we go. Drip pod. Yes. 45 slots. I'm actually quite curious at this point to see if I get a Steam achievement for filling out all the slots. There's a lot of stuff on this planet. I can see three points of interest just within basically like a 2 minute drive of each other. Bit of antimatter. So this week we didn't actually buy the resonator. I realised because I had two antimatter in storage and we've still got a load of chrysonite left. Might as well just make one. God, this feels slow. It can actually fling itself around fairly well, though. It's no colossus. Oh my god, there's another drop pod over there. So we found another pretty nice verdant planet, but it's quite... It feels quite different to Morrowind. It's got a bit more of a sort of subdued colour scheme, I guess. Also, we haven't seen any deserts yet, whereas Morrowind was half desert. Damn it. Okay, vertical walls, we still can't climb. Might be able to get up here though, because it's got a bit of an on-ramp. No, not quite. Alright, whatever, we're not here for POIs anyway, we're here to chase down ruins and monoliths. Where's that one? Oh, it's over there anyway. Quite close. Oh, damn it, come on. It's just a 20-foot vertical climb, for God's sake. Well, since we had to come this way, we might as well check this out. This is a colony post, looks like. We're in a GEC system. Hello. Friend GEC Federation, give help. The lifeform clucks and gabbles as it studies my equipment. It gently pecks at areas of my exosuit that show wear and tear, then runs its gloved fingers over my multi-tool to look for irregularities and imperfections. Suddenly staring up at me, it squawks an offer and spins a tablet that shows the cost of its services. Alright. The life form mutters, clicks, and gives me a new exosuit technology blueprint. Radiation deflector. Nanites. What do we have here? Shield restorer. And a little pistol. We're on a stock check. still have no idea what that means. No barrels or crates over there. So really, I'm not sure it even is possible to do, unless I'm missing something with how to escape those sentinels in space. I'm really not sure how you would play as a space pirate. It seems like you're supposed to be able to, but if you can't, like, fight your way clear of the sentinels and you can't run from them because they instantly spawn in when you drop one of them, I mean, how do you survive, like, a single pirate mission in space? Bearing in mind, probably the ship's going to be deploying, the freighter you're targeting is going to be deploying defensive fighters as well. Alright, well, we don't need that beacon, but we might as well have a dig in these barrels. Plutonium and knowledge stone is definitely worth stopping for. There's a lot of stuff on this planet. There's another one over there. Don't really want to go off course for it. And then there's another one down there. Right, let's gather some nanites. We're at the point now, we've got enough nanites back home and plus that one. We could actually check out what we want to buy. We must remember to go to the space station before we leave this system and see what the Gek nanite bloke sells. Okay, knowledge. Now then, let's see. I hear a low rumble, which gradually builds into an ancient scream. It's like no other noise I've ever experienced. To this strange alien landscape, it's a calm silence. Inside my helmet, it's a nightmarish cacophony of pain and death. Through the noise, however, I can make out some words within the screams. Toilgek, Yaopakanu, firstborn Poisfa? Nutux, Nutux, depart! Well, just purely based on the fact that it's screaming depart at us, I think we move away. The vengeful spirits that inhabit this place punish my disobedience. You told me to depart. Wait a minute, I thought they said it punished me. They gave me an Atlas word. And a Gek relic. And a Gek word. And some standing with the Gek. But apparently that's a punishment. That was a very weird one. It's like saying, we're going to punish you for not doing your homework by buying you a new Xbox? Right. So that's a monolith. Now let's see if we can... maybe we should do them the other way around, actually. If we go to a... Not that it's likely to make a huge amount of difference, but if we go to a ruin first, we'll get more words to potentially decipher the monolith with. Yeah, that seems reasonable. But anyway, how far away is that? Oh, that's the monolith. The ruin. Only 6 minutes. It's not so bad, really, the Geobaby slash Roma. It does feel a little bit slow compared to the Nomad. But, I mean, it's all relative. It's a nice enough vehicle to drive. Just doesn't have that sense of blazing speed and, like, flinging yourself off things and... it doesn't seem to jump as much. That might be because this one doesn't have the final tier of acceleration module, but even so. Oh, fuck, oh, no. God damn it. I just... We were about to just drive past another monolith. Found a monolith on the... Was it a plaque? It's a plaque. On the way to the ruin. Memories imbued into the rock long ago by the ancient Gek channel into my brain. I recoil but are compelled to somehow understand. The first spawn is the scourge of the outer edge. In its wake, empires will fall, planets will crumble, galaxies will kneel. Tremble at our name, for we are the almighty Gek. None can oppose our ascendance. Holy shit. Okay, well, I mean, if you haven't, it's been a while since we've hit up a Gek plaque. I mean, most of them so far just sound like that. It's just the Gek first spawn going like, fucking yeah, fuck yeah, Gek. Gek, woo, we're amazing. So, we did uncover a kind of snippet of story. Like the first spawn are not the Gek we see today. They're not the, like, little farting merchants. And if you haven't watched some of the episodes where we were interacting with Gek colonies and stuff, the Gek have a very strong, like, olfactory component to their communication. So half of your interactions with them is like, oh, this Gek releases a warm odour, or like a spicy or tropical fruity sort of odour or something like that. Yeah, they do a lot of farting, the Geks. It's part of their culture. Okay, we're gonna have to jetpack up this wall and just redeploy the Nomad up there. Nomad. The Geo Baby. Those power canisters are bloody rubbish. They're only worth about 30 plutonium each. What is that? Is that just terrain? That's also detritum. There's two different kinds of detritum on this planet. Actually, saying that, there are two different kinds of detritum on Nibelheim as well. There is a sort of underground version of... Oh, Jesus. Fuck me. There is an underground version of the detritum as well, which looks kind of like little stubby antrium plants that you can't mine on top of a big flat disc of rock. Oh, this is hopeless. We're never going to get up that. It is nice to encounter planets with their own sort of unique geology. I've never seen these massive basins before on any planet. And we've been to a fair few planets now, so it's pretty cool that we're still finding formations and geologies and stuff that we haven't seen before. I think part of that is down to the Pathfinder update, though. They did say they're doing quite a bit of work. Or was it the Pathfinder? It might have been the actual Foundation update, where they regenerated the universe. But they did quite a bit of work on, as they put it, making the planets feel more epic. And I think it's kind of shown. Obviously, some of the planets are still really dull and boring, but we've been to quite a few that have had a lot more interest to them. Right. Flickering emblems appear on the stone. Although I do not recognise the language, somehow I can read of the history of this strange planet and the Gek who once resided here. The first spawn grew. Weakling Poor Wiggle lost their tails to the spawning syrup and became mighty warriors. Each was imbued with the might of the Gek Dominion and its unquenchable will to claim the stars. The first spawn grew. Weakling Poor Wiggle lost their tails to the spawning syrup and became mighty warriors. Okay, I assume the Poor Wiggle are kind of like precursors to the first spawn then. Oh, but the spawning syrup. So are we seeing a bit of Gek prehistory here? So before there were the first spawn, there were the poor wiggle, and then after the first spawn were the little farty merchant dudes. Blimey. We'll have to keep an eye out for more mention of this spawning syrup. Okay, how far away are we from the ship at this point? Only 3 minutes, wow. That's a turn up for the books. We could go around and look for more monoliths, more plaques, but I think what I need to do at the moment is farm some iron. So, let me get the ship back. We don't need to farm Heridium this week. I'm absolutely positive we've got 200 of that in storage. We will need some Antrium, but we can get that just anywhere. I'm literally just blasting past POIs at this point. So we need plenty of iron. Once we get plenty of iron, we might head back. Yes. We'll head right into space and check out these nanite cluster vendor in this system. Then we can decide what we're actually saving up for. Because I think the Viking one was a bolt caster based. A bolt caster based offensive setup. Let's see. The surface of the plaque shimmers and shakes with the screams of a people that lived here long ago. The words are unfamiliar, yet in the sounds of Gek anger and outrage, I can hear meaning. Those born of the Gek who opposed the Dominion were hurled from the spawning pools of the first spawn. Their cherished spawning syrup was replaced with flame. Their kind are now merely beasts of the field. What the fuck? Spawning syrup. Okay, so that's a bit more detail about that. So this sounds like the spawning syrup is some kind of, I don't know, it sounds like a mutagen. Okay, so this is how the Gek Dominion was set up. Basically the first spawn, super aggro space bastards, and any Gek who weren't like that, they just replaced the spawning syrup with flame. They got rid of the mutagen that let them produce more of their kind. And their kind are now merely beasts of the field. So how did the non-first spawn manage to get through that? Okay, back at the ship. Now we need to figure out where the big iron is on this planet. These are obviously all carbon. These are plants. Weirdo. It's not those things. Those are the Tritum. Let's have a look. We want to find the big rocks. Big rocks. I can't see anything on this planet, really. Any massive reserves of iron. There's some little barnacles on the mountains that might be iron. We'd probably have to go, if we were like living here permanently, we'd probably have to go underground and farm stalagmites when we needed iron. Maybe we should just go back into space and farm it off the asteroids. Yeah, might as well go back to space and get it off the asteroids. Oh yeah, no, we need to repair this, don't we? I don't think we've got gold back on Nibelheim. I know we've got Emeril. Right, here we are back again. Let's sell the trophium. Any of the crap we've got hanging around that we don't particularly need? We'll actually see what the bartender's got to say as well. Right. The Gek relic. Okay. Trophium, 43 grand's worth. A couple of lemmiums. Might as well get that nickel. Why are resonators? Why are they so like above galactic average, like every system I go to? Never. Right, so gold, emerald, and like 4 antimatter and whatever. Excuse me. Oh yes, bartender. Something, something, inedible, nasal death. The trader pulls open a noisy trade vault. A close inspection reveals that it's full of writhing mollusks. They are pink, slug-like, and have sharp, bloodied teeth. The life form suggests that inserting one in or around my face would have some benefits. What I can't quite make out, however, is which orifice it means. Well, it's inedible, and nasal passage means death. I guess we put it in the ear. The slug burrows deep into my ear. I feel better versed in the language of the traders. Okay. Report. We knew, and obedient, we knew just enough words. Catalyst. Ooh. It was a 3-word slug. Very nice. Right, so the Gek Nanite traders, what do they have? You have nanite clusters? I can grant you blueprints for ship upgrades in return. Please, if I don't make my quota this month, they'll take my permit away. What the fuck? Cyclotron ballista. Infra-knife accelerator weapon mode. Infra-knife accelerator, positron ejector. Okay, so ship weapon upgrades, it looks like. I think we have to track down the right system and look for like the base module. So the infra-knife accelerator, the positron ejector, or the cyclotron ballista. Or we could just get the cannon damage theater, but we already know it. Yeah, so I guess we have to shop around a few different systems and find the base modules for these. And then we can start tagging on extras. But to be honest, what we probably want to do first of all is get like decent sized ships. And to do that, first of all, we want to get the freighter. Alright, well, I reckon that will do it for this episode of Let's Play No Man's Sky. Do hope you've enjoyed it. Next time, I'm thinking I might actually try that grindathon that I was thinking of. Just see if we go for a solid hour of farming and just see how much cash we can actually produce. The farm's not quite optimised yet, but it should give us at least a solid benchmark of how much more effort we need to put in to get a freighter. So I think it might be a decent time to do that. But in the meantime, that'll be it for this session. So I do hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game. And I'll see you next time.